Dear friends, welcome to another Arduino video tutorial. In this video, we are going to take a first look at this 2.8-inch color TFT display. It is a big, low-cost touch display, which is very easy to use. Without any further delay, let's get started. Hello guys, I am Nick and welcome to Educates TV, a channel that is all about do-it-yourself electronics projects with Arduino, Raspberry Pi, ESP8266, ESP32 and other popular boards. If you are new here, welcome! Be sure to subscribe and check the previous videos of the channel. Today we are going to learn how to drive the 2.8-inch touch display with the ILI9341 driver with an Arduino Uno and an ESP32 board. First of all, let's take a close look at the display itself. The display is big and it offers a resolution of 320 by 240 pixels. Compared to one of my favorite displays, the 1.8-inch color TFT display, you can see it is a lot larger. The screen also offers touch functionality, which is an added bonus, and an SD card slot at the back. It uses the SPI interface, so the connection with the Arduino is very straightforward. The cost of the display is relatively low. It costs around $11, which in my opinion is a fair price for what the display offers. You can find a link to it in the description below. Another thing I like about this display is that it does not come as a shield like the touch display we were using so far. This way we can connect the display to any board, the Arduino Pro Mini, the STM32, the ESP8266 and the ESP32. This is very important because now we have a low-cost display that we can use with every board. Until now, the only touch display we could use with this board were the next two displays, which are more expensive, and to be honest, even though I use them from time to time, I don't really like them. Now let's see how to connect the display to an Arduino Uno. The first 9 pins of the display are the power pins and the SPI pins. So, if we connect only the first 9 pins of the display, we can use it as a regular display without touch functionality. The display uses 3.3V logic levels and unfortunately it is not 5V tolerant. So, we need to use some 10K resistors if we want to drive it with a board that uses 5V logic levels like the Arduino Uno. We connect the display to the Arduino Uno according to this schematic diagram. We have connected VCC to 5V of the Arduino Uno and the SPI pins of the display to the hardware SPI pins of the Arduino Uno. Let's load a demo sketch now. As you can see, the 8-bit Arduino Uno with only 2 KB of RAM can drive this big display. But as you can see, it is very slow in updating the screen. It takes many seconds to update the whole screen, which is a pity. It can display text with more speed though. It is obvious that the Arduino Uno is not fast enough to drive a display with such a high resolution. It is obvious that we need a more powerful board to drive this display effectively. But can we build a useful project using this display? I wanted to find out, so I decided to build a simple real-time clock and temperature monitor. I added a DS3231 real-time clock module and I modified the code of a previous project to use the new bigger display. You can find the code of the project in a link in the description below. The result is not bad as the demo sketch. The project works fine, but of course, there is a small delay when the values on the screen are updated. In my opinion, this project demonstrates that we can use this display with an 8-bit Arduino only on very simple projects that update the screen rarely. Before moving to the more capable ESP32 board, let's try to use the touch functionality of the display. We connect the remaining 5 pins according to this schematic diagram and we are ready to upload the second sketch to the board. To my surprise, the touch demo works relatively fast. It is a simple sketch in which we draw on the screen using this stylus. I think this result is impressive if we take in consideration that this display is driven by an 8-bit board. Let's now connect the display to an ESP32 board. If you are not familiar with it, the ESP32 is a very fast and inexpensive Arduino-compatible board. I prepared a detailed review of this board a few months ago. You can watch it by clicking on the card here. Since the ESP32 board uses 3.3V logic levels, we don't need any resistors to drive the display. So, if we don't need the touch functionality, we connect the display according to this schematic diagram. If we upload the same sketch that used before on the Arduino Uno, we can see the ESP32 is extremely fast. It can update the display, draw graphics, and complete the demo sketch way faster than the Arduino Uno. Unfortunately, the Touch demo is not compatible with the ESP32 board yet, so I didn't have the chance to try the Touch functionality of the display. I will prepare another video about the ESP32 board and this display soon. First, I want to test more libraries and find a Touch library that worked with the ESP32 chip and build a simple demo sketch. Stay tuned! Let's now see the software side of the project. In order to use this display with Arduino, we need to install the Adafruit ILI9341 driver and the familiar Adafruit GFX library if we don't use the Touch functionality. If we want to use the Touch functionality, we also have to install the UR-Touch library. You can find links to all the libraries needed along with the code of the demo programs I showed you in the description below. As a final thought, I believe this display is a great display to use on our future projects. I think I am going to use the display a lot with the ESP32 and STM32 boards because it is easy to use, offers touch functionality, and it is relatively inexpensive. I am going to build a complete project around this display soon to test it even more and see what it is capable of. I would love to hear your opinion on this display. Have you ever used it in any of your projects, or are you going to use it in any of your future projects? Do you have any project ideas that we could build using this display? Please post your comments below and don't forget to like the video if you find it useful. Thanks! If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects twice a month. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel, to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. I'll see you in the next video.